Fort Baptist Church Youth Department annual Black History Program will be Sunday, February 16th, during the morning worship. The youth and the women of faith ministry will sponsor a soul food, potluck, potluck immediately after the morning worship. All members are asked to bring a covered dish and wear your African attire. Best please remember all those sick, shut in, those in prison, for we know that prayer does change faith.
Thank you. sing this song, I'm gonna look over the weather. Maria told me to just bust out with it.
Your country. contribution.
Amen.
Amen. We want you to keep it going.
Amen.
If you brought your Bible, I want you to look with me to the book of Matthew, the 14th chapter. Book of Matthew, the 14th chapter. And starting at verse 22. And straightway Jesus constrained his disciples to get into a ship and to go before him unto the other side. And while he sent the multitudes away, and when he had sent the multitudes away, he went up into a mountain apart to pray. And when the evening was come, he was there alone. But the ship was now in the midst of the sea, tossed with waves, for the wind was contrary. And in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went unto them walking on the sea. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, "It is a spirit." And they cried out for fear. But straightway Jesus spake unto them, saying, "Be of good cheer, it is I. Be not afraid." And Peter answered him and said, "Lord, if it be thou, bid me come unto thee on the water." And he said, "Come." And when Peter was come down out of the ship, he walked on the water to go to Jesus. But when he saw the wind boisterous, he was afraid, and beginning to sink, he cried, saying, "Lord, save me." And immediately Jesus stretched forth his hand and caught him and said unto him, "O thou of little faith, wherefore didst thou doubt?" And when they were come into the ship, the wind ceased. And then they that were in the ship came and worshipped him, saying, "Of a truth, thou art the Son of God." I want to talk about you too. Can walk on the water.
Amen.
You too can walk on the water. Leadership is exhibited in the life of Peter. You can't question that Peter was an example of leadership. He is the first to speak when a question is raised. He is listed first in the roster of disciples. He is one who was called to follow the Lord. He is the first to preach a sermon on the day of Pentecost.
Amen.
And yes, he is the first and the last to have faith enough to get out of the boat.
Yes, sir.
And walk on water.
That's right.
And go to Jesus. There's nobody else in the Bible that did this but Peter. So without question, Peter is an example of what true leadership is.
All right.
Leadership is nothing more than influence. Leadership is being able to influence others to follow you. Now, when we talk about leadership, is hard to find today. A lot of people want to be leaders, but a lot of people don't want to be followers. Now, there are five levels of leadership. And the last level, ain't nobody on that level, so don't even think about it. Ain't nobody, there are five levels, but ain't nobody in here on that level. Amen. So ain't no need you thinking you in that category, you ain't in that category, but there are five levels of leadership. The first level is position. Position is the first level where you just holding a title. You ain't doing nothing. You don't gotta follow you. But you got a title. And you can't get anything done. You can't move anything. If somebody gives you a task, it may get done and it may not get done. Position, just a title, so that you can feel good about yourself. Why don't you say amen?
Amen.
I'm not gonna get a whole lot of amen. The second one is permission. The second level is permission. This is where people will follow you because they want to. They follow you because they want to. They may follow you because they like you. They may follow you not necessarily because they feel that you know what you're doing. And even if you're doing wrong, they still will follow you. That's the second level. Now, that level is based on relationship. You can't be a good leader if you don't know how to build relationships.
All right.
Ministry is about building relationships. Mm-hmm. You see. In other words, you cannot do anything by yourself.
That's right.
Yeah. I cannot do anything by myself.
Okay.
Now, as well as we have able musicians that can play well. But even as well as they play, they still can't do anything unless they have cooperation.
That's right. So true. So true.
Nobody show up for practice. It doesn't matter how well they can play. They can play so well they can sit out in the car and play the instrument, but I mean, they cannot talk. If they can do that, it still would not be effective because you have to have cooperation.
Amen.
So ministry is about building relationships. And the only way you can build a relationship, you have to talk to one another.
Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you can't just talk to the person just when you want something from the person.
That's right.
Y'all missed out on that. Building relationship means that you are talking to people all the time. And if you build a relationship, they will be there for you when you need them.
Amen. Amen.
And they will be assured that you will be there for them when they need you.
That's right.
Because it is not a one-way street, it's a two-way street.
Amen.
You know, if you always going to the rescue of somebody else and they can't never do nothing for you, or they never got time for you, eventually that relationship is going to break down. Because in their mind, they're saying, I'm showing concern for you, but you're not showing concern for me. So it's all about relationship. Everybody say relationship. And then we can even go one step further. Even if we're talking about the church, if we're talking about working on a job, if we're talking about family, it's still all about relationship. Amen. The third step is The third level is production. Production. You can motivate people to get things done. In other words, you have a track record. That's production. That is, you have a way of producing. And every leader ought at least to be at this level, to be at a level of production. That whenever you are given a task, you can produce. You can produce. You can produce to the point that you can execute. Because you're executing on the behalf of the church. If you fail, the whole church fails. You see, if you fail, the whole church fails. If I fail, the whole church fails. So we're all in this together. You see, your desire should be that I succeed. Beyond expectation. Your desire should be that the pastor succeeds. Not that the pastor fails.
All right, that's right.
My desire should be that you succeed.
That's right.
And my desire should be to do whatever I need to do so that you will succeed.
Amen.
It ain't got nothing to do with you, my guy, you, my girl. It ain't got nothing to do with you. And you see, you can't get over the corner, this my guy, of this my guy. No, it's all our guy. It's all our guy.
Amen.
But the whole effort should be that I will do whatever I have to do to cause you to be a success.
Amen.
Because when you are a success, the church is a success. Now, I want you to think that this ministry is a small operation because it is not a small operation. It's a big operation. Matter of fact, it's bigger than you think. And it takes a lot of energy and a lot of dedicated people to make it happen. Amen. And it cannot happen unless you have dedicated people that are led by the Spirit of God. Amen. The fourth level is people development. People development means that you are able to replicate and reproduce other people that can do what you do. In other words, you know, if we got somebody that's operating in media, now, that's some sophisticated stuff up there. I don't know if you know it or not, but if you ain't got a whole lot of understanding, you ain't going to make it up there. Amen. But whoever is doing ministry needs to be reproducing themselves in the life of somebody else. In other words, it should be more than one or two or three people that knows how to operate the media. There should be more than one or two people that knows how to deal in finance. Right, say amen. Whatever it is that you do, you should be reproducing yourself.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Now, whatever I do, there are some young ministers that mirror what I do.
Okay.
Amen. And for whatever reason, they like what I do. They mirror what I do. Now, whether they continue in that, I don't know. But I know that I have taken time to pour into other young preachers what I know and what ministry should be about. Now, whether they stray away from that, that's on them. But at least I'm trying to lead them in the right direction.
All right.
Trying to say amen.
Amen.
Now, so you should be developing others and showing them what it is that you do, because one day you're going to die.
Yes. Yes.
One day I'm going to pass away. And the ministry should not die with me.
Right.
And the ministry should not die with you.
That's right.
Because you're selfish.
Because
I'm selfish. I don't want nobody coming along. This is not coming along behind you.
That's right.
But you want to know.
That's right.
You're not going to be here always.
That's right.
But the word of God must continue on. When Moses was in the decline, there was Joshua standing there in the wind to take the baton and lead the children of God into the promised land.
Yeah.
It didn't happen to the child. What are we going to do?
No.
God had already set up the situation whereby success had a successor.
Thank you, Lord.
Not just say amen.
Yeah.
You see, we serve at the pleasure of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, notice I didn't say the pleasure of the church.
All right, man. Okay.
I said, you serve at the pleasure of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Because, see, the church folk here let you stay there so they can control you.
Amen.
All right.
But when the Holy Spirit fires, ain't nobody hiding.
That's right,
Pastor. Number five. Y'all want to get hurt? Number five is pinnacle. That's where nobody's at. Pinnacle. At the pinnacle. At the top. At the top. This is longevity and intentionality. This is creating a legacy in what you do that transforms who you are.
Okay.
This is pinnacle. And this is the level that all of us need to strive to be on. It's being at the pinnacle where you can leave a legacy. Whereby others can follow the pattern that you have set. And the only person that we know has a perfect example is Jesus.
Why
you say
amen?
Some of our lives ain't fit to fall.
Amen.
Y'all, that's why I don't know that one. But if we really are serious about ministry and leadership, we should be striving to get to the pinnacle.
All right.
Where we have longevity and intentionality. That is, we have to do things intentionally. Then we have to intend to do certain things because it will provide a certain effect.
Yes.
Now, when we look at life of people, the first thing I want you to see is that Jesus had fed the multitudes and he gave the benediction. And then he goes tells the disciples to get in the ship and go to the other side, and I'll see your fellows there.
Okay.
He gives the benediction after he has fed the multitudes. He sends his disciples across the sea and tells them, fellows, I'll see you all a little later. He goes up on the mountain and he's by himself praying. That's the situation that we find ourselves in the text. And in the midst of this text, some unusual things happen that causes all of us to focus on what it really means to Now, the first thing I want you to see is that immediately Jesus shows up in the fourth watch. Now, I'm going to say more about that a little later, but I did drop this on you. The fourth watch is starting at 3 o'clock. And if you notice now, when you wake up at night and the Lord wants to say something or speak to you, it's usually at 3 o'clock in the morning. That's the fourth watch of the night. There's a reason why you wake up not at 1 o'clock, not at 2 o'clock, but you wake up at the fourth watch of the morning. The fourth watch is God's hour of revelation. Rabbis teach that God comes to the earth every morning during the fourth watch. And whoever is up gets a special revelation from God.
That's right. That's
right. Amen. Write that down.
Amen.
The fourth watch. I'm gonna say more about that a little later. But now, so Jesus comes and they get in a storm. And while they are in this storm, they are doing what the Lord told them to do. The Lord said, go across the sea and I'll see you fellas after a while. But Jesus is up on the mountain praying and looking at them while they're struggling on the sea. He looking at them. He sees. They scared. They think they're going to cry.
Yeah.
But he's looking at them.
Yeah.
And he sees them.
Yeah.
And he knows what they're going through in that struggle. But he lets them go through what they're going through. He lets them struggle while they are struggling. And he comes to them walking on the sea in the fourth watch.
All right.
And when he comes, they really think that it's a ghost. Because this image is walking on the water. So, naturally, they think it's a ghost. But Peter, he recognizes the stride of Jesus. And he recognizes the sway of his robe as he steps. And he recognizes that this is the Lord. And when he recognizes it's the Lord, he asks the Lord, if it's you, let me come out there.
That's what he did,
man. That's
what he said.
If it's you, let me come out there where you are. And Jesus doesn't have to say a whole lot for you to say to really go somewhere. No, he just said,
come
on. He didn't say, come on down here where I am. He didn't say, put your one feet. He just said, come. All you need is one word, say, Lord. And the Bible says that he stepped out and started walking. Now let me look at it from a mind of science and a mind of physics. You see, water is so unstable. And water never is still. It ain't never still, it's always moving.
Yeah.
Flying. Moving. And the lesson is that In life, there are so many uncertainties.
That's right. That's right.
That all of us have to step on and walk on.
All right. Amen.
That's right.
So, when Peter stepped out of the boat, you look at several things. There's a reason why you float. Buoyancy is based upon the density of something. Gravity is also involved. And then there is pressure on the object that is standing on all of this. So my point is, in order to go through the circumstances of life, there will be pressure. Pressure allows you to be able to handle some stuff.
Amen.
But then there's something called dynamic lift. You see, if you drive in a car, it can hydroplane.
Yeah.
In other words, it's riding on top of the water.
Yes.
And if you're not careful, it can flip.
Yeah.
So dynamic lift is anything that is moving fast under your feet where wind is involved, it gives you a lift. Find what is the next step. What is the next step for you in your journey? Let me drop this on you. Little boy was sitting at the table, and for some reason, he just stopped talking. And wouldn't say anything, and his parents got a little concerned about it. And he took him to the doctor to see why he had stopped talking. And the doctor said, nothing wrong with him. There's nothing wrong with him. I don't know why he won't talk. So one day they were eating breakfast. And the boy, little boy, he screamed out and said, the toast is burning. The toast is burning. And his mother and father, they were so happy he had talked. And his mother was in tears, got up out of the seat and hugged him. And said, well, why is it that you all this time, you haven't been saying anything? And all of the time today, you told us what was going on, and you've been so quiet. And he said, well, so far, everything's been pretty good. Here's my point. When you're in ministry, the only time you're going to hear people complain when it's something they don't like.
Amen. Amen.
Other than that, you'll be so confused, you wonder if you're doing a good job or not. Because they ain't going to never say nothing when you're doing good. They only going to say something if they ain't going bad. You can't let that discourage you.
Amen.
For faith always releases the supernatural.
All right.
Faith always releases the supernatural. The reason why Peter could walk on the water is because faith always releases the supernatural.
It does.
Yes.
If it's healing, if it's deliverance, if it's financial, whatever it is, faith always releases the supernatural. You see, what you can do, all you can do is all you can do.
Right.
And when you've done all that you can do, then God steps in.
Amen. Yes, he does.
Fear will always sink. Faith will always hold you.
Amen.
Fear began to sink because of fear.
Amen.
Faith will always hold you up. Jesus is our lifeguard who will save us from hopeless and drowning situations.
Yeah.
When we are above and it seems like we're going under, the Lord will be there to keep us from drowning.
Amen.
Yes,
He will.
Amen.
So many times I've been places, I've preached sermons, where the masses, people everywhere. And when I get up, I walk on my prayer, Lord, don't let me fall. Because I'm depending on you.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen. Whatever you're doing for the Lord, let your prayer be, Lord, don't let me fall.
Amen.
Life that seek to drown us, we can do it by faith. then when you look at the end of the text, the end of the text says that after it's all over, it said that they worship the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
This is the first time, church, this is the first time in scripture that the Bible says that they worship the Lord.
Yes. Amen. Yes.
All this is the very first time in scripture that his disciples recognized that Jesus was the Son of God.
Mm-hmm. All right, Pastor.
Because the Bible records that the wind was howling, the lightning was flashing, and when he got into the boat, the Bible said the wind ceased.
Yes, it did.
It just stopped. And he recognized that Jesus was the Son of God.
Yes,
yes. Remember on to the cross, yeah. When we're talking about the four wise, Jacob wrestled with God just before he realized his destiny in Genesis 32, that it was the fourth watch. When Moses walked across the Red Sea, it was the fourth watch. When the angel appeared and announced to the shepherd that Christ was born, it was at the fourth watch. And when the bridegroom comes,
Lord Jesus,
Matthew 25, 1 through 13, it will be at the fourth watch. And when he will walk on the water,
glory. Amen.
Have
mercy, Lord.
The fourth watch.
Amen.
My brother and my sister.
Amen.
If you don't remember anything else I told you,
all right, Pastor.
Remember, God will show up in the midst of your storm.
Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Yes, he will.
In the fourth watch.
Yes, he will.
Look for him and look to him.
Amen, Pastor.
God bless you.
Thank you.
serve the people and to serve this community and to glorify you in all that we do. And Lord, we know that we can do nothing without you. We can do all things for Christ that strengthens us. And Lord, I'm asking you to bless this ministry leader one by one, in name by name. May they not fall, may they not be in doubt, but may they stand in faith and in integrity and in honor and to glorify you. And we pray that the church will support them and help them to be successful, and that in the end, souls will be saved, lives will be transformed, and you will be glorified. Lord, we ask you now, we thank you for what you've already done, what you're going to do.
Yeah.